Vladimir Bubrin is my name. I was born in 1949 in a small town in northern Croatia, close to a town by the name of Đakovo, famous for two things, for its Lipizzaner horses and for its cathedral built by the famous Croatian bishop Josip Juraj Strossmayer. I remember that town because that's where I had my first ice cream. That's where my mom and dad bought me my first pair of shoes, and I have very fond memories of that little town. The village was very interesting. It was multicultural, in fact. What bound us together was that we were all Catholics. So we all went to the same church. And of course, as a good Croatian village, we were also passionate about soccer. So we had our soccer team, and irrespective of ethnicity, young boys would play soccer for the village team, and they were either heroes or bums, depending on how they fared in competition with other villages. My parents were farmers. They owned some land. In communist Yugoslavia, private farming, private land ownership was allowed, but extremely limited. So dad had a certain amount of land where he grew a variety of crops. So that was the main source of the family income and livelihood. When we arrived, it was late winter, early spring, March 2nd, 1961. It was very cold. Fortunately, there I have a picture of us on our arrival to Canada. We were all wearing winter clothes, even though Europe was already experiencing spring, but we had our winter coats on, which was fortunate. I started school in Croatia. In fact, I was in grade 5 before when we came to Canada. I don't know what day of the week it was when we arrived, March 2nd, but I'm pretty sure that at the earliest opportunity, we were taken to St. Helens School at Brocken College in Toronto. Children have a knack for learning languages. So learning English wasn't, I don't remember experiencing great difficulties. It was a gradual process, obviously. But in no time we picked up the language and were able to attend school with our peers. For the most part, yes. Mainly because they themselves did not speak English. However, at first, to encourage and then to speed up our learning of the English language, they did encourage us to make friends with English-speaking boys and girls. I remember Dad would take me to night school for additional English lessons. He was taking English lessons, so he figured, well, it won't hurt him if he comes with me. I was born into a very close-knit family, and we maintain a really close relationship, not only within the immediate family, but also the extended family. There's a tradition developing that once a year we have this extended family picnic, and one is coming up this Saturday, where we catch up on the latest, see the new kids who are born, and then everybody brings something. I know Marianne, my wife, is going to bake some pita and kugloff and things like that. Of course, the younger members of the family will bring their soccer outfits and boots and shoes and balls. And who knows, maybe even a soccer game will erupt.